We're going to keep it completely simple on today's leg day. I am so fried when it comes to my hammies. So when it comes to the hammies, that is going to be eliminated. Normally, I train all of my legs in one day. But I did like 6 days ago, and my hammies are still completely fried. So in this case, what we're going to start with is the hammy curl, but we're not going to work it out. We're just going to warm it up. Then we're going to go to the calf raise, and then from the calf raise, we go to the pendulum squat. And then from the pendulum squat, we go straight to hip thrusts. I think that's what we're going to do, and then adduction. And then we're going to call it a day, because it's really that simple.
It's an everything leg day, minus the hammies. So everything focused, minus hammies. Let's go.
Last time I used this, I don't know if anyone actually even watched my first video, but I nearly hurt myself on this because of the fact that it like slipped down, even though it's like completely secured. It's strictly just a quick warm-up. We're not trying to do anything insane with this.
Just a quick warm-up. I'm not trying to work it. Just like focus on that, so I don't...
We're not even heavyweight either. This is what, 106 pounds? I can already yell way more than this. There you go. That's it. That's all we wanted. Just a quick warm up. Get the knee completely lubricated. But now we gotta figure out how we're gonna do calves. Because if you go to the last video, I went to the calf raise machine and had to use the gym pin that I have. But even with the gym pin, I used like almost three plates. So I'm not trying to use like three plates on a machine that doesn't even have that much weight on it, you know? And then I ended up using the machine in front of me, which was just a seated leg press. That still kind of sort of sucked. So I think I'm gonna try to do it on the hack squat. Let's do it on the hack squat. Okay, this is gonna be us trying to figure this out. That's not gonna work on this. We'll do this, hold on. Let's transfer it over. Let's transfer it over. We're gonna go right here, and let's see if we feel something on this. Okay. Only issue is it has like no resistance at the bottom. I gotta figure this out.
I'll be right back.
I warmed up a little bit off camera, but even then, it feels so iffy. Like, I've never liked this machine, but I guess I have to come to terms that I'm probably gonna end up using it for the remainder that I'm here. It's the only downside to this gym, bro. We need more plates. Ooh. All right. That felt good. I'm about to show you how to train calves. Watch this. When you're training these, I want you to pay attention to how I set this up. I'm all the way at the edge, and I let that stretch happen. That is exactly where the growth in your calves are gonna come from. You see how, like, I'm taking advantage of going down slow and letting it stretch and then coming back up? You don't have to squeeze all the way up. Take advantage of stretching this, bro.
You're in partials.
Oh my god.
That burned.
Now we hit the pendulum squat, which is basically going to be the entire, like, effort. Everything is going to be put into this. I'm either going to fail or die. I have a toy to play with. I have a toy to play with, especially by Gym Reaper. They sent me a belt, and I've tried so many belts on the market, and that felt really sturdy when I tried it at home. So once we get into the heavy ones, heavy squats, then we'll put it on. But right now we're gonna feel this out to make sure it feels smooth. If you don't realize, I don't know if you can see it on this, but we're going on our toes on this. And honestly, I feel like I can put more quads into that when I go on my toes.
So let's add some more weight.
Look at it, bro. Look at it. Gym Reaper. That feels nice. Feels like quality. And I've tried a ton of trash belts back in my day. So we're gonna use this. I loaded two plates on here, plus one in the front, and a 25. Is this upside down? I think this is upside down. Really doesn't matter, right? Whew. I set the camera back as well, so that you can see the entire movement. We're gonna try to get 5 reps, because this pendulum squat happens to be pretty heavy. One more. Oh my god. That felt nice. Okay, we're gonna do that again. Same weight, same everything. Because firstly, when I tell you my ears started ringing, I needed at least 5 to 7 minutes. I took a break for like 5 to 7 minutes. There was no way I was gonna do another set without stopping my ears from ringing. You gotta train hard, bro. You gotta train hard. I didn't train for 10 years just to get no gains. I got gains. This belt is great though. This feels really comfortable. Urgh.
gotta go lower.
It's not coming up. It has to come up though. Maybe I do one more set. We at that point in the workout where everything is mental. I'm like contemplating right now, should I do another set or just go to the next movement? Because I want to do another set, but that took a lot. If I do another set, I have to take that 25 off. We'll do another set. We're gonna take another minute to just recuperate, but I really want to put it out there. How do you expect yourself to grow if you're just gonna do walking lunges, and if you're just gonna like do Bulgarian split squats or goblet squats or anything? How do you expect your quads to grow, or anything gonna grow, if you're gonna do movements that incorporate multiple things rather than isolating a certain movement? Like, I get that you're gonna grow, but I'm gonna let you on a little secret. If you want to grow a muscle, you should try to isolate it as best you can, even in those compound movements, because that's the muscle you're trying to train. Not the triceps with your chest, not the front delt with your chest. You're trying to train your chest. Compound movements. If you're trying to train your quads, compound movements. It has to be the same thing.
Compound movements.
Your quads, your glutes.
Try to eliminate that as much as possible.
Your calves.
Try to eliminate that as much as possible.
Your lower back, same thing. How do you expect yourself to grow? And then you got all these old gym heads that are swearing by compounds and everything. Like, guys, welcome to the new age. There are different things that work now, and better things that work. We know more. Get on the level of knowledge, knowing more. That's my pipe bomb for today. I really don't want to do another set, but I like the pump, and I like the fact that I was pushing myself. So we're just gonna go as hard as we can and fail as hard as we can. Because every set that I've done this so far, my ears start ringing, so. That's the goal.
Oh, this just feels so light now. It's not gonna feel light after what, like 5 reps?
So heavy now. That's it. My quads got nothing left, bro. They're fried. We're smack dab in the middle of the workout. I gotta do hip thrust next. But this has got to be the best belt that I've had so far. And that's not because they gave it to me for free. That's because I've tried a ton of belts. This actually is like sturdy and doesn't feel like cardboard. And I just threw it. Like, I love going to the gym and all, but without a shadow of a doubt.
Compound movements.
Like, dude. You gotta realize that your efforts don't mean nothing if you don't put it to work. I don't know what I'm saying.
Compound movements.
Click this in. And then we're gonna go. Okay. Maybe. Oops. I forgot. This machine is a little weird. We'll do a 35 because I am not as fresh. And I want to get at least 5 to 7 reps and be a little heavy. One thing you got to realize when you're doing hip thrust, you don't want to go all the way out. Like, the goal is to get as much squeeze as you can with the glutes. So when you're going to do it, make sure that you can probably push your hand under your butt and just feel it out that way. My muscle connection, guys, even though I feel like my muscle connection is a little overrated because people tend to overvalue it. Like, not feeling the muscle won't mean that you're working it.
Compound movements.
But it really does mean that you're still working it, especially if you're doing something like this, where your glutes are gonna work regardless. It is overrated, up to a certain point. Like, when you first start off into lifting, you should definitely take advantage of mind-muscle connection and try to build that. Like, I can sit right here, and I can flex pretty much any muscle in my body because I'm 10 years into this, and it's like second nature. I know what muscle I'm, like, squeezing. But when it comes to, like, beginners, I would say, like, taking advantage of training for the pump, training to get it, to let it burn, does have its advantages because you're still gonna grow. You're still gonna get phenomenal gains. Everyone does. It's new stimuli. But it will help you gain that connection so that when you're working out a certain muscle, you know it's working. It's not a struggle. You know how many times I've trained like back and my back like was fine, but when I'm training my back, my forearms and my biceps were like shot. It doesn't mean my back wasn't being worked, but it also means that my biceps and my forearms were just shot, you know? Those were being worked just as much, if not more than, because they were shot. They just couldn't keep up with my back. So, stuff like that, where I think it's useful. Wrist straps help, lifting straps help, but it's useful. You could have walked in front.
It's all good, bro. I know how it is.
It's all good. This dude just walked all the way around my camera. My camera's pretty far too. Kudos to him. But at least he was nice about it. I don't know. That's pretty dope. I'm gonna grab a 35. I'm yapping. That is so cool. The guy who walked right around me, he's praying right now. I believe he's praying Zuhr. I'm glad I got that out of the way when I came in. But if you're a Muslim and you're watching this, never skip it. Even when you're at the gym, the pump can wait. But if you're gonna miss it, it's the only thing separating you from being a non-Muslim. For those of you who are not Muslims, the more you know, right? I needed to get off of them for a second. We got a few things left. We're gonna go straight to extensions, and then we're gonna go straight to adductors. Okay, me just casually holding on to a seatbelt in the middle of the set. I'm using a seatbelt from Jim Pin. I saw TNF pull out of his last YouTube video, and it made me remember that I have a seatbelt. The seatbelt is like, I use a lifting strap usually, which is one like cheat code. But if you don't have that cheat code, what you can do is use a seatbelt. Get a seatbelt, attach it like a whole thing, be like Dora the Explorer, like seatbelt, so we can be safe. Even though in this case, it's not for safety. It's for holding you down nice and secure. I discovered... Okay, we gotta undo that. I discovered this leg extension machine that's like super tight that allows me to like get a nice stretch in the quad, so I don't have to resort to sissy squats. Because as you saw in the last leg day video, I resorted to sissy squats. The gym really livens up your day. I felt so sad and depressed and distraught at the start of the workout. And now I know I'm straight up. You saw that? I didn't even have to hold on. But the gym really, I feel the serotonin. I feel all the good neurotransmitters firing. We're going to blast this, though. Myo reps. The stretch was burning. Oh no. We'll put that there. The stretch was burning. All right, that was one set for that. That's fine. Code Cage at Gym Pin. I spent $700 on a WWE belt, and now I'm a champion of Gym Pin. So I can't use the adductor machine because someone else is using it. So in this case, we're going to skip it entirely because I don't even need to use the adductor machine. I just wanted to use the adductor machine. But since I can't use the adductor machine, we're just going to do a little bit of abs. And as of right now, I'm only doing one movement, which is just crunches. I've never even used this machine here, so we're going to go for it. Only issue is, where do I like brace? Can't like stretch. If I go high. Okay, maybe. I just need a stretch. I like the stretch. I want to stretch. That felt pretty nice. We'll do one more set. I will say, having the support of the elbows really goes a long way. Ooh. Oh, that felt really nice. But I don't know. Should I call it a workout? Dude's still on that machine. I guess this is a lesson to everybody that you don't always have to be consistent. I mean, consistency is key, don't get me wrong, but if you can't do a certain movement, substitute it out for something else. Maybe wait for it. In my opinion, I'm really not going to wait for it. But I don't know. It's really not that deep. If you miss one, you're in there and you're not going to compete on stage, it really doesn't matter. You're human. Things are gonna happen. It's not that deep. I'm pretty much done though. So if you're still here, you're freaking awesome. This gym is phenomenal. Look at this gym. This gym has everything, minus calves, bro. I'm still complaining about calves. But you can like see so many machines. I'm standing on like a turf and everything around here is just like aesthetically pleasing. Like there's a whole boxing gym and everything. If you wanna replicate my leg workout, by all means, go for it. I've been doing it for almost, what, 10 years? I've always combined everything on my leg day. I've only skipped out on hamstrings for today specifically because they're fried. I did like 6 days ago and like the top of my hamstrings are still like fried when I stretch down. So to mitigate injury and to know and understand and I'm not trying to tear down the muscle, I'm trying to build it. There's that. So we skipped hammies, but everything else is pretty much a done deal. Catch me on an arm day. I think the next one I'm gonna record is an arm day. I think that's the best way to go about it. And I think from now on, I'm just gonna straight train arms because no one can complain about having big arms and I've only ever trained arms maybe once or twice a month. So again, I'm yapping, so I'll catch you in the next gym vlog-ish thing.
Compound movements.